the music cry, Caesar! Speak! Caesar's turn to hear.
Beware the Ides of March!
A soothsayer bids you beware the Ides of March.
Simon Mormon, let me see his face.
Fellow, come from the throng! Look upon Caesar!
What sayest thou to me now? Speak once again.
Beware the Ides of March!
Ha! He is a dreamer. Let us leave him. Pass!
Will you go see the order of the course?
Not I.
I pray you do.
I am not Gamesel. I do lack some part of that quick spirit that is in Antony. Let me not intrude, Cassius, your desires. I will leave you.
Brutus! I do observe you now of late. I have not from your eyes that gentleness and show of love as I was wont to have. You bear too stubborn and too strange a hand over your friend that loves you.
Cassius, be not deceived. If I availed my look, I turn the trouble of my countenance merely upon myself. Vexed, I am awake with passions of some difference, conceptions only proper to myself. But let not therefore my good friends be grieved that poor Brutus with himself at war begets the shows of love to other men.
Then, Brutus, I have much mistook your passion, by means whereof this breast of mine hath buried thoughts of great value, worthy cogitations. Tell me, Brutus, can you see your face?
No, Cassius, for the eye sees not itself but by reflection some other things.
Tis just, and it is very much lamented, Brutus, that you have no such mirrors as will turn your hidden worthiness into your eye, that you might see your shadow. I have heard where many of the best respect in Rome, except immortal Caesar, speaking of Brutus and groaning underneath this age's yoke, have wished that noble Brutus had his eyes.
Into what dangers would you lead me, Cassius, that you'd have me look into myself, for that was not in me?
Therefore, good Brutus, be prepared to hear, and since you know you cannot see yourself so well as by reflection, I, your glass, will modestly discover to yourself that of yourself which you yet know not of.
The
games
are done,
and Caesar is returned.
As they pass by, pluck Costa by
I will do so, but look you, Cassius. The angry spots are glow on Caesar's brow, and all the rest are like a chidden drain. Calpurnia's cheek is pale.
Cosco will tell us what the matter is.
Antonio!